2022. What's looking to be another great year for new coasters, there sure is a ton of great new rides to go around. From the next-gen Vekomas, world-class Disney coasters, RMC Hybrids, and the unknowns, this year is sure looking to be another great year for us coaster enthusiasts. Ever since the massive spread of the worldwide pandemic known as COVID-19, parks have had to recover from the debt they may have been in, leading to some delayed opening too. A major participant in that is the SeaWorld Entertainment chain that, even though they already opened Texas Stingray in 2020 and have already confirmed the Icebreaker will open in 2021, there still is some other major coasters such as Iron Gwazi, Pantheon, and Emperor that are unknowns. All of this could lead to an even better year for 2022, as that's what I'll be going through in today's video, all the major coasters coming to parks around the world in 2022. But most importantly, before we start, if you are new to the channel, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more videos on coasters often, as it really helps the channel out tremendously. Also, if you want to see more, make sure to look at the link in the description where you can see all of the Coaster Thrill social media accounts, including Instagram, for updates and much more. But let's jump in to the video. To start off, we have the 2020 delayed coaster Aquaman Power Wave coming to Six Flags Over Texas in Arlington, Texas. This mock power splash looks to be a great ride for the state of Texas, as even though it may not be an original edition, Aquaman will still be a great fit. Since the opening year was moved from 2020 to 2022, they did make an improvement to the ride, as now it will have a turntable to allow multiple trains on the track and as well speed up the operations. In the hot Texan summers, this ride will sure be a blast, as it will be a great fit for the park that is Six Flags Over Texas. Heading over to Poland, we have Energylandia, which in 2022, they will be adding a Vekoma mine train named Choco Chip Creek. I know this may not be the biggest addition that has come to Energylandia in the past year, so they have been adding coasters at a ridiculous rate, such as Abyssus coming to the park in 2021. But this mine train still looks to be a solid ride for the awesome park that Energylandia already was, as this just adds even more to their collection, being their 18th coaster yet. Another overseas park getting a coaster is Farooq Somerland, which in 2022, they'll be adding Phonix, at least that's how I think you pronounce it, a Vekoma Wildcat. First off, this coaster, like all of the other new Vekomas, looks to be an incredible addition, jam-packed with so many great elements. This coaster has a great looking inside top hat, multiple solid airtime moments, fantastic conversions, some serious whip, and of course a station flyby that looks to be insane. We have already seen this on Let Coaster, which on both coasters that inversion looks absolutely insane, definitely one of the best moments of the coaster. Phonix will serve as a great number one for the park, as it also looks to be one of the best coasters in Denmark. But heading back to the States, we have one of the two fantastic new Disney coasters, Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind. Once again, another Vekoma, this coaster will be one of, if not the best Disney coaster to date, as this ride looks to be a masterpiece. Themed to, of course, Guardians of the Galaxy, the theming, as always, looks to be world class, as it is, well, Disney. I mean, what else did you expect? The location of this coaster is in the former building of Ellen's Universe of Energy, which that building is huge, and they had to build another building, just showing how massive this ride will be. The trains look awesome. Really everything about this coaster will be awesome, as the same will go for Tron Light Cycle Run coming to Disney World as well, this at Magic Kingdom. An exact clone of this coaster is already at Shanghai Disneyland, which in no way does that die down the hype for this thing. It still looks to be one of the best coasters at Walt Disney World. Without a doubt, this will take the cake for the best coaster at Magic Kingdom, especially since it is 23 miles per hour faster than their current fastest coaster, Big Thunder. I know a lot of people are super excited for this thing, including myself, as this will be another great fit for Walt Disney World. A smaller addition for this video is the supposed 22 coaster that is Sidewinder Safari as Imperla, Spinning Wild Mouse coming to Six Flags Discovery Kingdom. Really, what else is there to say about this attraction? It's another coaster that was supposed to open in 2020 but was pushed back to 2022 by Six Flags. It's pretty much your standard Wild Mouse clone that, though it may not be the biggest addition of the year, it will still add some diversity to Discovery Kingdom's lineup. As we get into the coasters that currently do not have a name or have not been fully announced, to start off, we have the three coasters coming to the brand new park, Lost Island. From the evidence that we have seen, one of the coasters is going to be the relocated Vekomas SLC from South America, a brand new Wacky Worm, and of course the relocated Kanonin that used to be at Liseberg. Of course, out of those three, Kanonin is going to be the superior ride as it is a super compact Intamin launch coaster with a great launch as well as some cool inversions. The other two coasters are really nothing special as currently this park is only a water park, so it's obviously super cool to see them get some coasters with their new theme park. Now let's head over to Fun Spot Atlanta where they'll be building this brand new RMC Hybrid that looks to be one of the best hybrids out there. It especially looks like that's the case because the layout was just leaked revealing where this coaster is going to be and what the ride layout is pretty much going to look like, and let me tell you, it is going to be a fantastic coaster. It will be a ground-up hyper hybrid that just sounds insane from what all has been leaked. There will most likely be elements such as a dive loop, 0G stall, huge drop, and just so much more. Funspot will want to break some records, so my bet is that they will go with the most inversions on a hybrid, which just makes this coaster even better. This coaster for sure came out of left field, as if Funspot correctly pulls this off, it'll most likely be the best coaster in Georgia and one of the best in the US. Once again, heading around the world, this time we are going to Japan as Fuji Q Highland will be spending big as this new attraction will cost 3.6 billion yen, which in US dollars is 33 million. Nobody knows what exactly this coaster will turn out to be, but when you spend $33 million, it is without a doubt going to be a huge addition. Some people have proposed that it could be the first ever RMC T-Rex, maybe it could be a Bantam Giga coaster. There are literally so many options that this coaster could be, you just can't go wrong. Whatever this coaster is, it'll most likely be one of the best new rides for parks around the world in 2022, especially with how much they are spending. Toning it down, we have a smaller ride at Du Jour Sommerland. This one is not as major because it is just a powered family coaster. It being the park's 8th operating coaster looks to be a solid fit for another great park in the country of Denmark. As we just wrapped up all of the overseas coasters, let's travel to King's Dominion where just based on the track pieces in the parking lot is an SNS 4D free spin. This will most likely take the spot of where the crypt used to be as it'll be themed to the jungle, supports already being painted like bamboo and the track being a solid green. I really do like this fit for King's Dominion. It is pretty much a current replacement for what was Volcano the Blast Coaster as this park really needs a new ride badly. Of course, this is not going to take up all of the space in the area as in the future, who knows how long it'll be. Of course, there will be a much bigger and better replacement being a proper predecessor to Volcano. Next, we have another brand new theme park, this one with the new coaster. Peppa Pig Theme Park. Located next to Legoland Florida, this will be a very small kiddie coaster as listed in RCDB. It'll just be one single helix. This coaster is obviously not going to be the main draw for the resort as it'll just be another ride for the brand new theme park that is of course Peppa Pig Theme Park. And for our last confirmed coaster, there is a Gerslau record-breaking coaster that is sure going to be something huge. Some of the candidates for this new ride are who else but Cedar Point, Silver Dollar City, maybe even Six Flags Fiesta Texas, but that is pretty unlikely knowing their history with Gerslauer. At first, one of the biggest options was Dollywood, but that was quickly debunked as they'll be adding a record-breaking coaster, but in 2023, so obviously it's not the Gerstlauer. I would without a doubt place my bet on Cedar Point, as when this coaster could open, it would be 4 years since their last coaster, and that's really the longest I could see the park going without a new coaster. For the records they would break, they could definitely make it the steepest coaster in the world while also breaking the inversion record, which I think that is what they will do. Right now, the current record holder is the Smiler Alton Towers, which this will definitely be a larger and more grander ride that sure looks to be a terrific coaster. But next, we have two not completely confirmed coasters, but highly likely is the first one at Six Flags Fiesta Texas. They'll be getting who knows what, them going to announce all of the information on this possible new coaster in about a month. There are multiple options for this coaster to be, from an SNS axis to a Zamperla. They have been teasing this coaster heavily for the past couple weeks, let's just hope it's not a disappointment. From the past years, Fiesta Texas really has done great with their new additions such as Daredevil Dive and of course Wonder Woman Golden Lasso Coaster, so expect this coaster to be decent. Me personally would really love to see an SNS Axis, as from when they announced this model, the concept to me really stood out, especially for a park just like this. It's most likely going to be a steampunk theme, as even though we do not have the most information on this new coaster, I bet it'll be a great addition for the park. And lastly, but definitely not least, is the possible Jersey Devil clone being added to Six Flags Magic Mountain in Valencia, California. Though it may not be what everybody wanted, since it is almost an exact clone of Jersey Devil, this coaster could still be a great fit for the park, as it has a ton of potential to be one of the top coasters in Cali. It'll be located right next to Riddler's Revenge and Batman the Ride, taking the former spots of Green Lantern and Tidal Wave, so I would definitely suspect a DC theme. My pick is the Joker. I think it would be super cool if it had dark gray supports and the track switching between green and purple. That would look great, as it's just so Six Flags if they were to name it the Joker. This coaster would be a great new addition to Magic Mountain's already stacked lineup, and it could make it even more of a great year for the chain of Six Flags. Now that ends all of the coasters coming to parks around the world in 2022, though you should remember, since this video is pretty early, there are going to be some more coasters announced, so definitely keep a lookout for those. But what do you think of this video? Make sure to post that in the comments below. I read every comment. Love what you guys have to say. And of course, if you are not already, make sure to like, comment, and of course, subscribe for more videos on coasters often. And see ya!